We went to the Aru Islands in Indonesia to photograph the greater bird of paradise. It did take several hours by boat up a channel and then hiking in through the forest to get to the location. And of course, the whole time I was thinking, what is this location going to be like? Is it going to be possible to get good pictures? Are we going to have a good view? Many birds of paradise display on the ground or near the ground in the lower part of the forest, and those are, of course, a bit easier to photograph and film. The greater bird of paradise displays up in the treetops, and when we got to the site, it was immediately apparent that I was not going to have a good enough view from the ground to shoot from the ground, and I knew I was going to have to climb up in the tree, make some kind of a platform and a blind up in a tree in order to be able to photograph the birds.
Here we go. All right, we got the rope over.
For Tim, having the ability to be an expert tree climber and taking his 6'7" frame up into a tree and sitting in a cramped blind and waiting for 7 or 8 hours for a bird to show up and get the images. There are very few people on the planet who probably can do that. A good example of that is the work that we did on Greater Birds of Paradise.
There, now here's the lek right here. See these branches right here? This is the main display perch and the secondary perch there. And there's my blind over there where I've been shooting from. And right here is my leaf camera.
And now we had two ropes up two different trees. And the first thing Tim had to do was climb the tree in the dark, get the camera set up, climb back down, go over to the other tree, climb that tree, get in, set up his big camera, set up the laptop, plug everything in, and basically pray that it was all gonna work, because there wasn't any more opportunity to climb back down and fix it if it didn't work, because the sun was coming up and the birds were coming.
Ever since the beginning of the Bird of Paradise project, I've been sort of dreaming of a shot where I could see a bird in the foreground and be looking out over the rainforest in the background. And I saw the shot download in my laptop, and I said, like, that's it. I knew I had it. That was a real exciting moment where, you know, I had said that sense of success after all these years of sort of dreaming about a shot like that.